Hello and welcome to the channel. This is quite an oldie, 50 years old at least. I had to solve it several times because each time I lose my previous solution. Hopefully this time it will be safe on YouTube. As usual, each letter stands for a particular digit from 0 to 9 as we use the decimal system, while each digit corresponds to no more than one letter as not all the digits are expected to be present. However, if you count the letters for this puzzle, you will find that there are exactly 10 of them. 10 letters, 10 digits, perfect one-to-one correspondence. This could be used for solving the puzzle, but I didn't, being too lazy to count the letters at start. If you succeeded in finding a shorter solution, please share it. And now, hopefully short and hopefully useful introduction. So I number the column from 1 to 6, right to left, and since each digit is no more than 9, the value for the column 1 is no more than 18. When the value is a two-digit number, 10 or more, the number of tens is added to the next column. A number carried over to the next column is called carry, and for the carry I will use hash sign, also called pound or sharp, with the column number producing the carry. So for column number 1, the carry may be either 0 or 1, and it cannot be more than 1 as the number of tens for the maximum value is still 1. For column number 2, the sum is still no more than 9 plus 9, but we may have a carry from column number 1, which we already know is no more than 1. So the total value will be no more than 19, and still the carry will be no more than 1. Now we proceed to column number 3, and still the value cannot be more than 19, and the carry cannot be more than 1. And so on. And this is of course the common fact for any sum of two numbers, like we have Donald plus Harold. For three numbers, like Donald plus Harold plus Joseph, for example, the carry would be no more than 2. For n number, the carry is never more than n minus 1. For this particular puzzle, however, the carry for column number 6 is certainly 0, otherwise we would have an extra digit in the sum. Therefore, for column number 6, we can write D plus H plus possible carry from the previous column number 5 equals R. While in case of a carry, we would have 10 plus R instead of R as the right hand side. For the column number 5, we have O plus E plus carry from number 4, but we don't know whether this column produces a carry, so we need to consider two cases. When there is no carry as the value is just O, or when there is a carry and the value is 10 plus O. And these cases have to be considered separately. So let's start with case number 1, and since the carry for column 5 is 0, we can drop the last term in the equation for column 6. Then we note the letter O appears at both sides of the equation for column 5 and therefore can be removed. So we get just E plus carry 4 equals 0. And since both terms are non-negative, then E and carry from column 4 must be 0. So we found the value of one letter, and since column number 4 does not produce a carry, we can write the equation for column number 4, which is N plus R plus carry from column 3 equals just B. We continue with case number 1. When there is no carry for column 5. Now we move to column 3, which has one known letter, letter E. And we write 2a's plus k from column 2 equals either 0 or 10. We see that both results are even, therefore the left-hand side must be also even. And this may happen only if there is no carry for column number 2. So we can write the equation for column number 2. 2l plus k from column 1 equals just r. Also, since carry 2 is 0, then a can be either 0 or 5. But 0 is already taken by e, so a must be 5. And we found the value of another letter. And we know that column 3 produces a carry. So we substitute 1 for carry 3 in the equation for column 4. The carry for column 1 is still unknown, and there is nothing better than consider two subcases. Subcase 1.1, where there is no carry for column 1, and subcase 1.2, when column 1 produces a carry. And we start from case 1.1. So we can drop carry 1 in the equation for column number 2 and write the equation for column number 1, which is just 2d equals t. We see that sum d plus h evaluates to r. Since value 0 is already taken, d and h must be all positive. And they are different, therefore one of them must be 2 or more. Hence r, which is d plus h, is no less than 3. Also, the equation for column 2 shows that r is even. Therefore, possible values for r are 4, 6, and 8. And we consider each possible value separately. Assume r to be 4. Then l, which is half of r, equals 2. Then we have d plus h, which is r, equals 4. And the only way to represent 4 as the sum of two different positive integers is 1 plus 3. We don't know which stands for d and which stands for h, but we know that numbers 1 and 3 can't be used for any other letter. Then number 0 is taken by e, and number 2 is taken by l, and numbers 4 and 5 are taken by r and a. Therefore, the least number remaining for n is 6. Now look at the equation for column 4. It gives b equals n plus r plus 1, which is not less than 11, in which case b cannot be a single digit. This eliminates case r equals 4. If r is 6, then d plus h is 6. That can be represented as either 1 plus 5 or 2 plus 4. But number 5 is taken by a, so 2 plus 4 is the only possibility. From column number 4, we have b equals n plus 7. So for n 3 or more, b is not a single digit. N can't also be 2, since number 2 is taken by either d or h, and n can't be 0, taken by e. Therefore, n must be 1, in which case b is 8. Therefore, t can't be 8, and d, which is half of t, is different from 4. This suggests that h is 4 and d is 2. Then t, which is twice d, is 4, and this clashes with h. Guess what we are going to do for r equals 8. Take the equation for b. Since n is at least 1, then b is not less than 10, which is of course impossible. So case 1.1 didn't give a result, and we move to case 1.2, where there is still no carry for column 5, but column 1 produces the carry. So we have 1 added to the equation for column 2 and 10 added to the equation for column 1. Now 2D is not less than 11 and therefore D is not less than 6. Therefore R is at least 7. Also from column 2 we can see that R is an odd number. Therefore the possible values of R are 7 and 9. If R is 7, then D must be 6, as it can be no more and no less. And H is 1, so N must be at least 2, in which case B is at least 10, which is impossible. And when R is 9, then B would be N plus 10, which is again impossible for a single digit. This concludes case 1. And we move to case 2. Case 2, where we assume a carry from column 5. Again, we are facing tabula rasa. Forget all the results, none of the letters is known, and previous assumptions are no longer valid. Now we have plus 1 extra for column 6, and for the column 5, we have now O plus E plus carry from column 4 equals 10 plus O. And again, letter O appears at both sides of the equation. And we drop it and we get E plus carry from column 4 equals 10. Now we see that if carry 4 is 0, then E is 10, which is impossible. Therefore, the carry from column 4 must be 1 and E is 9. Again, we have a value for E, but this time, 0 is unknown. This raises a question about D and H. Typically, it is assumed that a number cannot start with 0, but to make it more challenging, I will ignore that. In fact, only H can be 0, as if D is 0, then according to column 1, T must also be 0, which is disallowed. This time, column 4 produces a carry. So the equation for this column will be much less usable than in case 1. Again, we know letter E in column 3, but this time the equation for this column will contain 9 and 19. Now, both values are odd, and in order to get an odd value for the left-hand side, we must assume carry for column 2. This gives the following values for A. Number 9 is taken by E. Therefore, A is 4 and there is no carry for column 3. The scenario repeats. We again have value for A. We also can drop carry 3 in the equation for column 4. Since we know that column 2 produces a carry, so let's write the equation for this column. 2L plus carry from column 1 equals 10 plus R. Again, the carry for column 1 is undefined, and again we have to consider two subcases. Subcase 2.1 with no carry from column 1, and subcase 2.2 with a carry. So what case I'm going to start with? Of course, case number 1. So we drop carry 1 in the equation for column 2, and we write the equation for column 1, which is just 2D equals T. From the column 1, we see that D is no more than 4, and from column 6, it follows that R is no less than 1. While the column 2 provides the equation for L, and for L to be a whole number, R must be even. Since value 4 is taken by A, the possible values for R are 2, 6, and 8, starting with R equals 2. Then D plus H equals 1, but D is non-zero, therefore D is 1. And T, which is 2D, equals 2, which clashes with R. The next case, R equals 6. We have D plus H equals 5, and this can be represented in three ways. However, 0 plus 5 is impossible, as D is non-zero and no more than 4. 1 plus 4 is also eliminated, as value 4 is already taken by A. How about 2 plus 3? If D is 2, then T is 4, and this clashes with A. While when D is 3, T is 6, and this clashes with R. And the last chance to succeed, R equals 8. Then L will be 9, which is already taken by E. Bad luck again. And our last hope, case 2.2, when both columns 5 and 1 produce a carry. And we have plus 1 for column number 2 and 10 plus for column number 1. From the column number 1, we see that D is at least 5. Therefore, according to column number 6, R must be at least 6. Then we evaluate L from column number 2. So, for L to be a whole number, the value of R must be odd. This leaves 7 and 9 as the possible values for R. However, value 9 is taken by E, so R must be 7. Therefore, L is 8. Now, consider possible values for D and H. Since D is not less than 5, there are only two combinations, 5 plus 1 and 6 plus 0. And D must always have the highest value. Take 5 for D and 1 for H. Then T is 0. And from column 4, we get an equation, N plus 7 equals 10 plus B, or N equals 3 plus B. No clashes so far. And if you find two unused digits which differ by 3, the puzzle will be solved. So let's build a table of used digits. 0 for T, 1 for H, 2 and 3 are still unknown. 4 for A, 5 for D, 6 unknown, 7 for R, 8 for L, and 9 for E. Do we have two spare digits that differ by 3? Yes, we have, 6 and 3. So B is 3 and N is 6, while digit 2 can stand for nothing else but O. And this is how the sum looks like. So far, so good. But let's complete our challenge and consider the last case. D equals 6 and H equals 0. In this case, T is 2, and again N equals 3 plus B, but this time there are no three digits that differ by 3. Therefore, even if we assume that a number can start with 0, the puzzle will still have a single solution.